Good morning. Today we're going to be talking about transcending your three and four dimensional reality and how to step outside of the dimension of time. The vast majority of human beings are perceiving in a very three-dimensional way. Now, for the most part, let me just explain to you right now, three dimensions are the way that you perceive the world: height, width, and depth. They consider height, width, and depth to be the first, second, and third dimension. For a very long time, both philosophers and scientists, quantum physicists, have been trying to decide whether time was actually a part of dimensional reality. And back, if you go all the way back to Einstein and special relativity, they began to discover that they decided, yes, we believe that time is a part of one of the dimensions, and so they consider time the fourth dimension. I'm going to throw a spin on all of this. I am no quantum physicist. Obviously, if you didn't realize that, you should. But I would like to throw kind of a little spin on that and talk to you about how time is a perceptional dimension, but that it is not the fourth dimension. And so I want to talk to you about it being the zero dimension and how we can begin to transcend that zero dimension, first, second, and third dimension, and begin to step over into some of the higher dimensional realities and what exactly that means. For the most part, people are living in a zero dimension. A zero dimension, if you were to talk to a physicist or a quantum physicist, again, I'm not that, is just a dot. It has zero dimensions. It's just a dot, zero dimensions. If you take that dot and you draw a line and another dot, now you have one dimension. Okay. And so again, we have height, we have width, and we have depth. For your eyes to be able to ocularly perceive anything, and for their eyes to work, it needs those three dimensions: height, width, and depth. If your width, if your is not working, if your peripheral vision is not working correctly, you have a very hard time focusing in on an object. And so you need to be able to have all of that. And again, to be able to see, be able to perceive. This is just a very basic understanding of what three dimension means. However, I want to talk to you about the zero dimension, or that dot, that one little line. Again, a zero dimension is a dot, and then you have a line. If that line, in order for that line to connect, that zero dimension to connect anything else, I want to call that zero dimension time. In order for it to connect anything else, you have to draw that line. When we draw that line, we put another dot, now we have one dimension. Now, for us to be able to take this zero dimension and incorporate it into our life, I'm gonna tell you, this is what happens. Time is the zero dimension, the very foundational dimension in which you're building the height and width and depth, and in which you're perceiving the height and width and depth. Now, this is how the mind works. What is real is just in your mind. If you fall asleep at night and you go to sleep and you're dreaming, and that dream might seem and absolutely incredible, it seems so real, and you wake up, you might forget that it was a dream. Was your dream less real than what you're doing outside of that dream? I would argue that it's not less real or more real, but that it's just a different kind of real. It was still perceived, it was still experienced, it was still being explored, it was still being created. There was something beautiful in that dream. Now, that dream, what took place there, did not happen in time. And so your mind is going to have a hard time computing or making sense of that dream. That dream happened, it happened in a, that experience, that reality happened in a dream state, which was free of time. Your mind was either it was probably in a very low end of theta brain waves, and so you were in a very trance-like state. That's a timeless state of existence. So you throw out that, if you will, again, I'm talking about time as the zero dimension and not the fourth dimension. So just bear with me. We're going to throw out that zero dimension, and now you're experiencing three things three-dimensionally, height and width and depth. And if you're tripping enough, you're experiencing things beyond that in a crazier dimensional way, which I'll talk about in a minute. But that zero dimension is what we have built our entire lives upon. That time is what we build our entire lives upon. So most people, their experiences are kind of marked by time. They're living a very linear existence. This is me when I was born. This is me when I die. 2 points. This is a one-dimensional reality, or it's called the zero dimension. And I am somewhere on this linear time between my birth and my death. And all my experiences are existing on this linear time, and this linear timeline makes me who I am. Now, that's how the vast majority of human beings feel and what they're experiencing. But what if you're more than this one dimension? Now, you're experiencing things three-dimensionally, height, width, depth. But all those height, width, depth experiences are happening on this one-dimensional plane. They're not happening. This isn't one dimension that then is incorporated into all the other dimensions. When you're having an experience, if you're truly present in the experience, like ultra present in your experience, then you're not even aware of the time during those experiences. Only later your mind factors all that experience in and places it on this timeline. So it's as if I am this one-dimensional being that is having these three-dimensional experiences. But you're not a one-dimensional being. You are actually light. In other words, you are actually the space in which this entire experience is unfolding. When you begin to step into and transcend this three-dimensional world that I'm talking about, it's almost as if time itself is being swallowed up. It's unfolding like a flower unfolds, except I want to talk to you about unfolding in reverse. So this is when time is beginning to unfold. There's no backwards and forwards on the linear timeline except in your mind. But what happens when we do this on the linear time? What happens when the linear timeline is gone and there's no backwards or forwards? You don't know whether you were born first or you died first. You don't know whether or not which experience came first and which experience came second, whether you learned to walk or crawl first. What happens when that zero dimension or the one-dimensional reality that you've been living in, what happens when that reality gets swallowed up? I was driving the other day. We were just driving to the river with my family, and we were driving. And this kind of experience happened to me every single day. But as I'm driving, I literally had to kind of like slow down at the brakes, because it was as if all that I was seeing in my mind along the road as we were going through this windy road in the mountains, everything was being peeled back. And so it was coming in like this. All of creation, all the trees and everything were coming in like this, and then kind of disappearing, and then unfolding and reappearing, and then unfolding and then reappearing. And it was like this, it was as if space was being consumed and then unfolded, consumed and unfolded, consumed and unfolded. And it was just a really trippy drive. I mean, it was ecstatic. It was awesome. But what happens when this is not have, see, those kind of experiences can begin to take shape when you're no longer having a linear or a one-dimensional mindset, a one-dimensional life. The one-dimensional life has set you up for failure. This one-dimensional life called time, the linear mind, has created in you this idea that you have to have a purpose, that by the time you're a certain age, you should be successful, you should be making X amount of dollars, you should have a family, you should have a career, you should fall in love at this point. You should be making love at this point. Like, this is kind of way society has been set up. And it's not that they know that they're doing it, but they've been living as this very one-dimensional being. Look at me. I'm 50 years old, or I'm 40 years old, or I'm 21 years old. And it's this idea that this is who you are as a 21-year-old being. This is who you are. and your entire life has been from 0 to 21. This is who you are. And you have all, but you have all of this linear time ahead of you that you're trying to create based upon everything that you've perceived from 0 to 21. That's what being a one-dimensional being is. Being a extra-dimensional being, now let me just, I'm going to use this word to describe light, an extra-dimensional being. You are the light or the space in which all of this is unfolding. If you want to play in that one-dimensional, that one dimension or the zero dimension of time, you can just realize that it is unfolding within you. You, life, light, are literally swallowing up this one dimension of time, this linear dimension of time, continually. And your mind, free of needing to operate in those beta brainwaves and moving through alpha, theta, delta brainwaves, experiencing, exploring, playing in the mind of the light body, get to begin to, you can still perceive to some degree. I will tell you, for me, I honestly a lot of times don't know what happened yesterday. And if it gets jogged in my memory, I don't know if it happened yesterday or if it happened last week or if it happened last month or last year. Those things all blend together. And the memories for me are very sporadic at best. Sometimes I can't, like if you tried to ask me about a child's birth, I might not even be able to have any memories about it. And other times memories will just come. Memories aren't the problem. The problem is we've adopted an identity based upon this one-dimensional reality or the zero dimension. When we start to, the way to transcend this three-dimensional, four-dimensional reality, if you count zero dimension, one, two, three, the way to begin to transcend that is to begin to move your brain from the beta brainwaves into more of an alpha and a theta brainwave. Some of the way that we do that is through breathing techniques, and we're going to talk a lot about those in September in our metaphysical mindfulness class. But there's all kinds of techniques that you can use to begin to train the brain to move beyond those beta brainwaves to begin to experience a new perceptional reality. The very first way, though, one of the very first steps, I talk about letting go a lot, but one of the very first steps is to begin to move beyond the mind, to simply recognize that this one dimension is not what you are. You are not your past. You are not the 0 to 21, the 0 to 50. You're none of this, you're not this being at all, but that you are literally the light, if you will, the light being the photon in which the space, the photons in which all of this experience is unfolding, is taking place. And you can live in such an out-of-body way that you are experiencing this consciousness unfold before your very eyes. And this is high. This is so high. The other thing is when you begin to tap into what I'm talking about in a high, as a higher dimensional being, you'll begin to not be able to understand the way that things are working. For instance, I'm looking out through the window here. There's a tree branch hanging over the window. It's about 20 feet from the window, probably. All of that is three-dimensional, what I'm describing to you. But now what I'm describing to you is this. There is a green substance waving in my vision, and it is levitating in, it's either levitating in the sky, or the sky is the substance in which this these green beings, these green living, waving, moving, wiggling things are playing. If I were to describe that to you, you would never say, that's a tree. However, that's what I'm experiencing right now here. And these leaves are coming in and out of conscious perception. They're moving in and out. They're changing shape, form, shifting in and out of my conscious perception. That is a normal experience. I understand and I know that you're going to call those leaves. And if I'm going to communicate with you, I would call those leaves the leaves of a maple tree, so on and so forth. But that's not what I perceive. My perception has shifted dramatically because the depth, the height, and the width are not the they might still be the primary way I'm walking and I'm moving, but it's not the primary way that I'm perceiving and experiencing life, in the sense that my mind is now translating in a higher dimensionally way. It's translating through many other dimensions. And so I'm seeing, for instance, a fourth, a fifth, a sixth dimension, like this is a cube within a cube within a cube. Have you ever been in like a funny house where you're looking into a mirror and you're seeing yourself times 100? That's you moving from a singular dimension, a third dimension, into a multi-dimensional being. That's what that is. But now let's pause right there. You are seeing yourself 100 times over. So instead of it being linear, this is me. I'm moving to this point. I'm trying to get to this point, but this is me between here and here. These two lines, this is who I am. That's one dimensional. Now this one dimensional being steps into that funny house and sees itself times 100. Which one are you? And it starts to trip. It can't understand who I am. Which one of the reflections that I'm seeing is who I am? And is the one that I'm seeing who I am, or is the one that is seeing who I am? In other words, is what I'm seeing what I am, or is the one that's actually seeing what I am, or is none of that what I am? Maybe the question, who am I, is a stupid question. Maybe that's a one-dimensional question, and there's an I associated with it. Maybe you're none of those things. Maybe this is just one big unfolding that you're consciously playing out and experiencing in a very multidimensional way. But you've forgotten that, and as a result, now you're living as this one-dimensional being. All of that comes to an end, including the idea that you're here and that you have all this mystery that lies behind you when you step away from this zero dimension and into the higher dimensional reality, time. Not only is suspended for the most part, but it's completely obsolete. And this is a beautiful, beautiful thing. I think maybe tomorrow I'll share with you a few trips that I've had, some experiences that I've had. Should be on the lookout tomorrow for 420 and for the next video. This, guys, this is so important. I know it might just sound, for a lot of you, it might just sound like this is some bullshit. For others of you, are like, wow, yeah, that's what I want. But just understand, this is actually something that's really, like, it's real. This is intense. It's beautiful. I trip out on this shit all day long, every day, and am really enjoying it. And I can tell you right now, since moving from being a one-dimensional being to the realizing what I truly am as light, has completely altered and shifted everything. Every experience is seen in a very different way because I'm no longer identified as the one having the experience. But I'm realizing that I am simply the experience. I am the space in which this experience is unfolding. I love you. You're absolutely amazing. Thanks for watching today. If you haven't already, be sure to subscribe. Check out the next video. It's pretty fucking awesome. We'll be right back.